Hello friends, welcome to KSP Academy. The last class we already completed two, three different types of conductors. We completed solid conductors, forward that standard conductors. Out of that we completed composite standard conductors also we completed. Now switch on to that fourth important type of conductors, nothing but bundle conductors. Out of that these bundle conductors are very famous in our transmission and nowadays. So that's what we need to more focus on, the bundle conductors. So what do you understand by bundle conductors? The bundle conductors are like just standard conductors, but in this the number of standard conductors will be more in a single phase. That conductor should not be touched to each other. Bundle conductors are the conductors in each phase we have number of conductor, two or more subconductors in each phase. So what I should say that the bundle conductors in this bundle conductors in this two or more subconductors, two or more subconductors in single phase. In single phase, these conductors do not touch to each other. Do not touch each other. Let us take a standard conductors. All conductors are touching each other, but in this, it should not touch each other. Let us, I should explain it is to understand it easily. Let us take, we have a R phase, Y phase, and B phase. R phase we have a two conductors like this. Y phase we have a conductors like this. B phase have a conductors like this. Each phase we have two or more subconductors in a single phase. These conductors do not touch each other. Such a type of conducting system is called as a bundle conductors. I think we have seen number of things. Let us have a three conductor system, a triangular model. R phase, Y phase, B phase. This is also called a three conductor system. I think we are already seeing four conductor system also. This is all already we are having in our market. Please go at outside of your near to the villages or outskirts. Please visit here. This is a four square model also. We have four conductor system. We have observable system also. How came? There are so many cases. People will heard, I think so. Six octagonal system. This is when hard is hard. Anybody wanted to go and visit that, you can see it. Octagonal system, hexagonal, like this. See, hexagonal model. So second, three, four, six, like this. The different models have it. Such a type of each phase, single phase, you have like this system. These types of conductors called as a bundle conductors. So what is the main purpose of these bundle conductors? The main purpose of the bundle conductor is to reduce the current loss. Want to see here? I will write the important points in that bundle conductor. Why we should go for bundle? What are the advantages of your bundle conductors? So the right advantages of your bundle conductors. Number one is to reduce the current loss. To reduce the current loss. Second important thing is to reduce the reactance. To reduce the reactance of the line, these bundle conductors are going to be useful. One more thing, to reduce the radio interference. To reduce the radio interference of communication lines, that's also we have to see it is. One more thing, to reduce the voltage gradient. That's also important. Reduce the voltage gradient. To reduce the reactance, to reduce the current loss, to reduce the radio interference. One more important thing, to reduce the surge impedance also. Reactance nothing but automatically impedance also should go to reduce. The main purpose of bundle conductor is to reduce the current loss, radio interference, voltage gradient, surge impedance. 2 to this 4, the coronal loss is very important. To reduce the coronal loss only, today we are going for a long transmission line, high voltage and to go for bundle conductor scheme. So, how to reduce the coronal loss by using bundle conductor? We have a separate topic, we will discuss very clearly. Bundle conductor for a coronal loss. Next, what is the coronal loss? The loss class I was already discussed due to the coronal loss. Please watch the coronal loss. To reduce the coronal loss, how you go for bundle conductors. And after next class, I will explain if you use the bundle conductor, how coronal loss should be reduced. So, major thing is this is the bundle conductor scheme. This is the advantage of bundle conductors. I hope you understand little bit information with respect to bundle conductors. Next, we have the fifth different type of conductor. Nothing but fifth type of conductor. Hollow solid conductor. The fifth type of conductor called hollow solid conductors. Fourth one, hollow solid conductor. What is understood by hollow solid conductor means we have a conductor. We are making it in the hollow shape. So this is not a total portion should be covering like a pipeline. So this is the portion should go to this. This is called as a hollow solid conductor. In between there is no material like a just pipe. It's like open pipe model. Open pipe model. Remember hollow solid conductor. Why we should use this hollow conductor means to reduce the skin effect. Skin effect, one more thing, to reduce the conducting material, to save conducting material. Why is what, how you can make, let us, we have a total complete material, okay now, with this total conducting material, if you open this material, if you open this particular material, if you remove this material, it should make one conductor. This conductor is called as a solid conductor. This portion is not useful to, that's what we have such a skin effect. So wasting of conductor material, that material can use, remove it is, we can save the conductor material for the called as a solid conductors. I hope you understand it, solid conductors. Advantage is to save the conductor, little bit to reduce the skin effect up to the mark. So even though we use the solid conductors to save your conducting material, that skin effect is not up to the mark. Again, they have a skin effect. If you use a solid conductor in this, it is up to the mark. The current should be concentrated in only surface area. Something we have a skin effect. That is what we have to overcome in the next conductor. One more drawback for this disadvantage is, what is the disadvantage of this conductor means? It will occupy more space. More cross section area. Because if more space means it will cover a more area for R phase, Y phase, B phase, this big line support is required. Is the problem with hollow solid conductors. Next, one more thing is to reduce the skin effect. Still some more, we have to go for another conductor, nothing but a hollow standard conductor. To hollow standard conductor means what you have to do? This is a hollow conductor. There are all 7 pipelines are making it a hollow. In this there is no material. Only this material they are having. They are all hollow portions. There are 7 woven pipes are making it. Small small pipes. Same thing you are making like this. If you use in such a way, the skin effect is less. Skin effect is going to be reduced. The skin effect of hollow solid conductors compared to hollow static conductors, skin effect is reduced. The fifth different type skin effect is less reduced to sixth. The hollow solid conductor skin effect is reduced compared to hollow solid conductor by making a standard conductor making. This should be twisted together, you can make it out. Skin effect is reduced up to the mark. Again, there was a problem, it is a such a type of things also you have to be take more space. That is a common drawback, disadvantage of this hollow stand conductor. More space it occupies. The second very dangerous problem, very important problem is the construction is not so easy. With very complex design, for a design like this, it's not so easy. Complex design. The complex design will take place because manufacturing process is not. It is difficult to manufacture such a thing. After make it thin to increase the tensile strength. One more thing, like use like this, tensile strength also should going to be reduced. Skin effect reduces, tensile strength also that is also problem. So make it strengthen like this. Again, you can go for inside composite alloy standard conductor. Again, you can use steel inside composite standard conductor. You are using a steel alloy material. Then after that, that's a more extensive topic. It is that you can discuss in the more than gate levels. IAS we will discuss it is. How you are understanding? This is the 6 different types of conductors I was completed in the last classes. If you like my interesting topics, my way of teaching style, please make a subscribe. You'll get the links to your mail ID. You can continue to watching. Thanks for watching. Keep continuing.